Hi students, let's continue with this HTML tags. The another type of tag is the table tag. So this is one of the important concept tag that you need to be know, because if you want to represent any data in the form of a table, you need to know this concept. Otherwise, you can't print a web page with a table format. Okay, so it is useful to display the data in 2D format. Tables are also powerful tools for formatting the web page. So for formatting the web page, these are the one of the most powerful tool that we used in the HTML. So let's see. If you want to create a table, you need to know the basic tags. These are the basic tags that we used. Table. The table, everything, you should have the opening and the closing tags. Open and closing tags. Whatever the message that you have printed, that is represented in the form of that particular thing. A table. It starts creating the table. TD is nothing but the table data. One cell of the data. Okay, whenever TD is used, open, it create one cell. And if you create another cell like this, it creates the cells in the table. Means the rows, it is columns, it is going to be created. And next, TR is going to create a row. It's just create a row in the table. TD is going to create the columns for one cell of the table, and TR is using for the number of rows, and TH is optional. If you want to represent that particular matter in a bold format heading, you can use TH. So let's see an example to understand this TD, TR and TH. So HTML body, table border. Table border means how much width you want. It's a light or it's dark. Okay, or it's somewhat light like this. A table should be appeared border. Like this. A table borders. So based on the size of this, you can the table border will be appeared. So row has started. Okay, first row is started. First row is started. So TR, I didn't close that row. I just started the row. So whatever the matter I have written, that table data, a cells will be created. Whenever I close the row, then only it enter into the next row. A TD. So first A cell is created. TD close. Again in that particular row only. I didn't close the row. TR I didn't closed. I still open in TR. Again in that particular row, another will be created. Another cell. That will be closed. Again TD I have opened in that row only. C is created. So now I close the row. Now it shifted to the another one. See here. So let me take here. A table is created like this. This is a border size. I have written it as a 4. So A, B, C. So now next, again next, coming to the next row. So in the next row, the first cell is created with, second row is created, the first cell with the D. D is, that cell is closed. Again, open another cell. E is created. And close that cell. Again, another cell is created. F. So, I close that row. Whenever I close that row, I shift it to this next row. So, I started TR. The first cell is created G. And the second cell is created with H. And close that cell. And third cell is created with I. So, TD is for creating the cells. So, whenever the TR is there, so I close that, I'm moving to the another row. So I'm closing the table also. So only it created 3 rows and 3 columns. So don't forget to close the table, close the body and close the HTML. Okay. So this is a basic, these are the 3 terms that we mostly used. TH is optional and TD and TR is a table. Is the 3 terms that we mostly use it to create the tables. So row and the data. Now let's see the attributes for the table. So attributes means what format that you want. It's a border size. How much border you want. It's a thick or dark, whatever the size of the border. And the border colors. You can also change the colors also. This border color you can change to different colors. Red, blue, green, pink, whatever color you want. You can create the border colorful table. You'll get the colorful table. And the align, where I have to start my table. In the middle of my page, corner, right corner, left corner, middle, down or whatever that should be the alignment. Okay, so now let's see this borders, attributes of the table tags, border, border color and the align. The border is used to set the border of the table, and the border color is used to change the border color of the table, and align is used to setting the alignment of the table. So whatever I said, I have written in the message. Now let's see the example to explain this. HTML head title table. So here whenever it is there, table is created with the title table demo. Table demo. So the body is started. So here I'm using the table border is two size. Means the table border is two size. And it should be aligned center. In the center of the page, a table is created. Okay. And first row. Whenever I created a first row. Okay. In the first row, the message should be, the first cell should be students. The first cell should be students. So that close that cell. And the second cell should be in the same row. I didn't close the row. Okay, in the same row, I created another cell, that is the teachers. Now close this row and close the table. Don't go for the another row. Don't create another row because I close the table and close the border and close the HTML. So this is the output for this program. So the web page consisting of like this, a table with two cells. Next is the nested tables. Let's see the nested tables. Nested tables means tables within the tables. A table within table. Let's see. HTML body and the body whenever a table is created. Means page is created. So in this page, a table border is 2. Okay. A table border is 2 and it is aligned center. So in the center, a table is going to be created. Caption. So I am giving a caption, means the table heading I am giving a caption. Whenever you use this caption, whatever the message that is appeared in between caption, open tag and the close tag, that will be present like this in the center of this table. It's a caption. So first row is created. So in the first row, okay, so this is a table. Okay, a table. The first row is created. In the first row, a data will be the section. First row data will be the section. So close that cell because TD is closed. Again open TD, that is the second cell. So this is, I didn't close the row. Okay, in that particular row only one cell contains a section and another cell contains again the table border. So table border here a size is 2. Okay, in that the first row is created TR, the data is A. Close the data and another data in that particular row is B and close the row. Whenever I close the row, it goes to the next row. So again, so this is completely in this cell only. TR, the data is C, close that data and again open that and D. So this is a nested table. Okay, so this is completely comes to one cell. Now I am closing the TR. The complete TR I have to be closed. Okay. So here two TRs will become complete TR I am closing. So whenever I close the complete TR, a table will be closed. Because final table is closed, TD is closed, TR is closed. Okay. This is the inside table is closed. This data is closed. This table is, row is closed. Again table is closed, body is closed, HTML closed. So I just confused here. Don't write here because this is a nested table. Only this table row is closed. Whenever this row table is closed, complete close that table. Okay. And come out. The data has to be closed. This is completely comes under one TD, one cell. So TD has to be closed. Again, row has to be closed and final table has to be closed. So this is the nested tables. Okay. By seeing it will be confused. But if you do the practice, it will be very easy. You can make a fun of creating the tables in the web page. Okay. If you know the if you understand the topic, it will be very easy to create a different tables with the nested tables. Everything you can be created. But one thing is you have to follow the format. When you open the row, a first row is created in that first cell section. Second cell. In the second cell, I created one more table. So a table border 2. In that a row a data, a row, a data. So after that, you have to close that table. Okay, after closing that table, you have to close this cell. That is a TD you have to close. Again, if you're closing that TD, you have to close the complete row. Cell is closed, complete row has to be closed, and close the table. So that format you have to be checked. Thank you.